Well, hello, Shoin. This is your devotional for May 5th, and we're continuing through Proverbs. We're in Proverbs chapter 18. And like I promised you last week, saying there's a lot about our words and the things we say in the book of Proverbs, we're going to focus on the power of the tongue and our words again, because we can go deeper into some of these topics and some fresh insight. And so prepare your heart and your mind to receive a few words of encouragement from the book of Proverbs. In chapter 18, verse 21, there's this kind of overarching passage. It's really powerful. Listen to these words. The tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. The tongue has the power of life and death. What Proverbs is saying is we can kill people, not probably literally, but metaphorically. There's probably ways, even verbally, that we can kill a person's reputation or even lie about a person to the point where our words have power, the power of death, but also the power of life. And every time we speak, we should just recognize we're unleashing a power to either build people up and encourage them, or potentially to tear them down and to damage them. So here's some words about our words from Proverbs chapter 18. Verse 2 says this: fools find no pleasure in understanding, but delight in airing their own opinions. They delight in airing their own opinions. That could be a overarching declaration of our culture right now. Everyone delights in airing their own opinions. And of course, our opinions are right. Always. I mean, that's that kind of the thinking. Well, it's my opinion, so it's got to be true. It's got to be right. Actually, there's objective truth. And I'm pretty sure that my opinion on a lot of things is probably not all that accurate. It's just my opinion. But people love to air their opinions. Be careful. Be careful when you're going to tweet something out, when you're going to post something, when you're going to declare something. Slow down. Pray about it. If you're a follower of Jesus, say, Lord, if this is just my opinion, I better not push it. If it's the word of God, if it's truth, I can come with greater strength. I still want to be gracious, but I can come with greater strength. And be very, very careful that you don't conflate your opinion with God's opinion. Man, this is a real problem for Christians today. We think our opinion on almost any topic must be what God thinks about things. Slow down, go to the scriptures, be humble, and don't assume that your opinion is always right. And then in verse 8, the words of gossip are like choice morsels. They go down to the inmost parts. Talk about an honest verse. It says, man, gossip is delicious. It tastes wonderful. There's something incredibly tasty about talking about things about other people and hearing things about other people, that gossip process, but they're deadly. Gossip is deadly. Gossip is a sin. And that means both ways, speaking words of gossip, but listening to words of gossip. So here's a challenge from Proverbs: be wise and don't get engaged in gossip. Verse 13 says this: to answer before listening, that is folly and shame. And when someone's talking to you about something and they're kind of laying something out and you go, blah, let me give you my answer. Now slow down. To answer before listening, that's folly and that's shame. Slow down. Listen. This is a growth area for me. I need to learn to listen to people, and not just listen to their words, but what they're saying and their heart. So listen to what people say, hear them out, catch what's happening in their heart, their expressions, and boy, in your marriage, in your friendships, in your workplace, you will be in better relationships if you slow down and listen to what people say. And then finally, verse 17. And this is so insightful. And I think in our world today, because there's so much judgment going on of people before both sides are heard. Listen to verse 17 of Proverbs, verse chapter 18. In a lawsuit, the first to speak seems right, until someone comes forward and cross-examines. Yeah, boy, in a lawsuit or in an article, in something that's posted online, that seems right. That seems to make sense until you hear the other side. Here's one of the problems in our world right now. We're not listening to the other side. We become so one-sided, we only listen to one side of things. And so you can hear one perspective and it seems right until somebody cross-examines and says, well, is that really true? Did that really happen? Did it happen that way? Was that the tone? Is that a fragment of what happened or the whole story? So here's a challenge. Be slow to judgment. In our world today, when the news cycle isn't like a daily news cycle, it's like a moment-by-moment, hour-by-hour news cycle. When you hear something, don't move to judgment till you know the whole story. Guard your mouth. Don't pass something on when you have fragments of what's been going on and act like you're passing on the truth. Our words are powerful. Use them to be a blessing. Use them to encourage. Use them to speak grace. And if you can't speak grace, in most cases, slow down, shut it down, and let silence, communicate that you're walking in wisdom. I want to pray for you. Lord Jesus, I pray for everyone listening. I pray for myself that this powerful instrument we have, our tongue, our mouth, our words, the ability to write words, to text words, to put words out there in the world. Lord, we pray that you give us wisdom in every word we speak, in every word we write, every word we type. Let us hear from your word and shape our words to bring you glory. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.